I went to 10 schools in 12 grades, which is a lot of schools. It's a lot of schools. And we moved around a lot in different houses. We were renters. We were lifelong renters, you know. So lifelong renters come with their own sort of obsessive moves. So my dad had, the grass is always greener on the other side, okay? So we're moving from place to place to place. And then my mom had, the rental house is greener on the other side. So even within the same neighborhood, we could possibly shift homes. You know, so you had a little bit of that. What comes with it are good things and not so good things. But one of the good things that comes from it is that you meet a lot of people. You're coming and going all of the time. And you have to find out how to be with people. If you're going to make friends quickly. You have to have some skills for doing this, you know. You have to face up to people. You have to, and being able to tell stories or talk, you know. You can't just be like the new kid who walks silently to your person's door, knocks, and doesn't say anything. You've got to have a shtick. So that really helped, you know, to like get some personality going. My sister had a journal, had a little diary, and she would write in it. And I was kind of a copycat, you know, like a younger brother type. And so I would watch her, and I thought, dang, she's so good at that, you know. And then I thought, well, if I read it, you know, I'll probably be as smart as she is, because she was always smarter than me. And so then I did read. I read her diary. It was a terrible, unethical thing to do, but I was compelled. And so I read it, and it wasn't terribly interesting to me. I mean, I'm not trying to run my sister down, but it seemed to me that she was missing all the richness of life. Here we were moving from Western Pennsylvania to Cape Hatteras to Barbados to St. Lucia, you know, to Miami, you know, lots going on. And all these neighborhoods we would live in, all these crazy characters, and none of that made the diary. And I thought, that's really peculiar, because the world I'm living with and in is really interesting. So I got a diary, and then I started like keeping notes, and then I started trying to set the diaries up in such a way that they would be, well, they would help me get started. You know, because that blank page, you know, when you look at that blank page and you put that on the desk or open a diary, it's really hard. It's intimidating. It's begging you to improve upon it. And it's hard. Every time you put that pencil down, you've sort of sullied the page. So then I did this thing. First, I'm a reader. You know, I was a good reader. So I'd read Harriet the Spy. And Harriet the Spy had a diary, and she walked around the neighborhood spying on everyone. And I thought, that is the greatest job in the world. I want that job, spy, you know, because I was good at looking in windows. And so I went out, and I got a big sheet of paper, and I drew a spy map of my neighborhood. And then I started drawing where everything interesting happened, you know, the low supervision family over here, and you know, my family, and where my dog was eaten by an alligator in Florida, and where the other one, you know, was hit by a car, where the third one dug a hole, ran around the house, fell in, broke his neck, we buried him in the hole he dug, and the little things like that, all that kind of stuff. And then I would write, you know, I would open it up, see that map, and knew right away that I could focus on those stories and write those stories.
Funding for AdLit.org is provided by the Ann B. and Thomas L. Friedman Family Foundation. For more information on adolescent literacy, please visit us online at www.adlit.org.